द स्टोरीड हाउस। वामन गोविंद होवल इज़ वन ऑफ द मोस्ट वेल नोन मराठी राइटर्स फॉर हिज कंसर्न फॉर दलित्स हु आर द विक्टिम्स ऑफ सोशल इनजस्टिस। होवल्स शॉर्ट स्टोरी द स्टोरीड हाउस इज़ ए पावरफुल सिंबल ऑफ दलित अवेकनिंग इन इंडिया। दिस स्टोरी पोर्ट्रेस द वर्स्ट सीन ऑफ द कैस्ट सिस्टम बट ए पावरफुल एनरिचमेंट ऑफ दलित्स फ्रॉम नोवेयर ए व्यू ऑफ होप प्रिवेलिंग विथिन देम। इट कंट्रीब्यूट्स ग्रेटली टू द डायनामिक्स ऑफ दलित एमांसिपेशन। इट टेल्स अस द हार्ट रेंडिंग स्टोरी ऑफ बायाजी हू बिलोंग्स टू महर ए दलित कम्युनिटी ऑफ महाराष्ट्र। बायाजी हैड एम्ब्रेस्ड बुद्धिज्म टू एस्केप द सफरिंग्स ऑफ अनटचेबिलिटी। बायाजी हैड वर्कड हॉनेस्टली फॉर ए पीरियड ऑफ 35 years इन द डॉकयार्ड एंड रिटायर्ड फ्रॉम हिज सर्विस। बायाजी हैड क्रॉस्ड 60 बट वॉज इन ए साउंड हेल्थ। हिज बॉडी वॉज वेरी स्ट्रांग। आफ्टर हिज रिटायरमेंट बायाजी रिटर्न टू हिज नेटिव विलेज विशिंग टू स्पेंड द रेस्ट ऑफ हिज लाइफ पीसफुली एंड कंफर्टेबली विथ हिज फैमिली। ही ट्रैवल्ड बाय बस टू रीच हिज विलेज। एज सून एज द बस स्टॉप्ड ही गॉट ऑफ द बस पुट हिज बॉक्स ऑन हिज ओन हेड एंड बिगैन टू वॉक towards his house. As he reached Kadam's house, Bayaji saw Bhujaba, a known rascal of the village. Bayaji greeted him saying, "Greetings to you, sir. How are things with you?" On hearing this, Bhujaba became serious, as Bayaji was a mahar by caste and according to age-old custom, Bayaji should have greeted him with, "My humble salutations to you, sir. Who are my father and mother?" Bhujaba asked him if he thought he could become a Brahmin merely by saying greetings. Bhujaba also asked him whether he could forget his position simply as he had turned Buddhist. Bayaji was confused and thought of knocking Bhujaba down with his box. But he couldn't do it as he had come back to his village to spend the rest of his life there. He thought that it was not a good policy to incur the hostility of anyone in the village. He told Bhujaba in a meek tone that he came to the village to stay there till the end of his life. He also told that his service was over as he had turned 60. Bhujaba asked him greedily how much fund amount he had collected, and Bayaji replied that it was some 2,500 rupees. Bhujaba wanted to swindle 400 or 500 rupees from Bayaji. Bayaji reached Takya, Buddha Vihar, in the untouchable settlement. On seeing him, the children scampered towards Bayaji's house, crying out, Baizunana was there. When Bayaji's 85-year-old mother heard of his arrival, her heart swelled. His wife concealed her joy with the end of her sari and took down the box from his head. His grandchildren clung to him. His mother poured some water over the piece of bread in her hand, moved it around Bayaji's face and flung it away as an offering. Bayaji's family was a big one. He had 8 children in all, 6 sons and 2 daughters. His daughters had been married off and had given birth to children. His elder son looked after the fields, and the next 2 sons were in government service. The one after them was a school teacher, and the 6th one was
still studying. They came home to greet Bayaji. All of them wondered what their father had got for them from his lifetime's earnings. But they were dissatisfied to find that their father had bought them nothing valuable. His elder daughter asked him how it was that he hadn't brought anything for them. Bayaji was amused with their attitude and told them if he had brought them new clothes, they would tear, and if he had brought them an ornament, it would soon wear out. Bayaji told them that he wished to build a storied house out of his earnings. They were all happy with his decision. The foundation stone of the storied house was laid on the New Year Day.